for the Sabre.
I saw in the trailer that there was a lot of fighting.
Yes.
Because it's about this blade and how you use it.
Yeah.
Tell me about that.
We are the professional swordsmen. So that was our background from the big movies that we were working on in the past. We were in the stunt teams, we were preparing the choreography for one of the biggest productions in the country. So let's say that stunt background was that impulse to get much deeper into filmmaking. And approaching that project from the far beginning, we knew that we really want to make a wonderful fighting scenes. So 2 weeks, we were filming, trying, doing different things. Me and Bartek, we were using swords, and guys around us were filming everything. So we invent, I think, very unique way of filming fighting scenes. And that time spent together on that process helped us with achieving one of the best duels in the cinematography. And I'm pretty comfortable with saying that, because I really think that what we did on the set and what you will see in the movie later on, it's very well done.
It's interesting that many people who have become successful in film come out of a stunt background.
Yeah.
A team of people who choreograph and execute stunts for other productions, and then they realize that, oh, there's a camera. Where would the camera best be for this? Because I get presented with stunts now. They come with a fully cut sequence that they'll show me on the phone. So we think you should shoot it like this. It's already, and they've figured it all out, where we should be with the camera, what lens we should have. It's quite amazing. And as stunt people are a growing contingent of amazing filmmakers that are being unleashed on us. It's interesting that I had a stunt guy on a show 20 years ago, Stad Stahelski, and of course he is the one who went on to be John Wick, and he's the director now of John Wick.
That's what I thought when you said about the stunt guys getting into the filmmaker, because we all really like John Wick.
Your camera was moving all the time.
I think
one of the important things that people forget is that we're making movies, and so everything has to move.
Yeah, it's a motion picture.
Yep. So it seems that the strength of your storyline really comes back to the saber and how it was used in warfare in the 16th century, right?
Yes, exactly. We put a lot of attention to giving a viewer the actual knowledge about how it was used in the past. So this choreography that we did for this movie is actual techniques from the 16th and from the 17th century. So we did the big research about it. You know, we recreate that technique and we used a real steel swords. So it wasn't like a plastic thing or like aluminium. It was a real dangerous weapon that you can get hurt with.
So the sword, saber.
Yeah, curved sword.
It's so essential to the storytelling that you wanted to make.
Yeah.
I like the fact that it's very grounded in the reality of how you use that weapon to fight. And so you approach every scene with how did they do it? So it's always grounded in historical fact. And I think there's a lot of people tell stories without the depth of the grounding. And so it is a very cohesive thing to help you tell the story, the knowledge of the blade.
That was the approach. And when you do the historical movie, you need to pay attention to things like this. It's all about details. It's all about these little things that actually make a difference. We really tried to be as much realistic as it's possible, and to, you know, keep the balance between being filmic and being correct historically. So that was the approach.
I think it's exciting because for many people, they feel that without a film school education, they can't move forward. But I see that you guys just got together and you formed a group that perhaps most people who go to film school, that's one of the positive things that comes out of it. They have a small group of people that they work with, but you already did that.
Yeah.
And now you got the equipment and you paid for all of this by doing jobs, commercial jobs in between.
Yeah, exactly.
And so
that's how it works.
It kept you alive. And I think the the internet now provides so much knowledge that some people, this is a much better approach and you're learning on the job. Did you make any mistakes in the process? Did you have to go back and rethink something?
I don't know, should I say that? But I will, because that was a part of that production. We didn't use at all ND filters.
Yeah.
We bought some ND glass. Before, it all fell apart after the first day.
Yeah.
So it was no choice and we didn't have any additional solution. So there was a crazy idea about, okay guys, so we go up with the shutter speed and that's how we control the exposure.
Uh-huh.
And a lot of people are very afraid of the final result. You know, it's gonna look a bit clunky, you know, it's gonna be too sharp, you will have no motion blur. We knew that shutter speed doesn't affect that much the image, like for example frame rates does, because we were doing a lot of action scenes, it yeah. actually helped.
Of course, the action
because there
helped.
Was a lot of movement inside of the frame, yeah. so the shutter speed, you know, helped us with achieving yeah. even a better look of it.
Yeah, Saving Private Ryan.
Yeah.
Yeah, basically. Yeah, no, fantastic.